think IQ tests are objective evaluations of our mental abilities, but in reality, they are deeply biased and controversial tools that might not predict intelligence at all.
Emily, don't embarrass yourself. Measuring intelligence is what IQ tests are for.
Wrong again. The first IQ test was never intended to measure intelligence. In fact, it was invented in 1904 as a way to assess which French kids were doing well in kindergarten.
Wine is to lunch as cigarette is...
to recess.
Excellent! You are now ready for the French first grade.
Huh, that's awfully specific.
Well, the inventor of the test, Alfred Binet, said that was the point.
My test is for children. It is not meant to apply to everyone.
But that all changed thanks to a man named H.H. Goddard.
I'm going to apply this test to everyone. Hey, everybody! Let's all take this intelligence test.
People liked intelligence testing so much that within a few years, IQ tests had swept the nation.
This test says I'm a regular Marie Curie. I'm positively glowing.
Mine says I'm dumber than a dewdrop or all zazzled on a Sunday.
Well, I'll never marry you now.
And today, we use them to tell how intelligent we are. End of ruin?
Nope. The only thing IQ tests tell you is how good you are at IQ tests. Early tests focus almost entirely on concepts that only rich white folks would know.
That can't be true. I'm not rich and I can answer these questions. Describe everything required by a regatta. Okay, boats, water, and... wait, I don't know.
My God, he forgot buoys.